eventually this kingdom was going to fall drastically, you see. So sometimes, have you ever had to speak a word and season to somebody? And you know it was God, but you didn't want to give it? Pastor James, you can relate to that, I'm sure. I have. I've had to speak words that I knew were God, but sometimes people don't want to hear them. But that's okay. We've got to be obedient, and we trust God to do the rest. So he and many others were going to die. And the dream described how King Nebuchadnezzar's kingdom would be divided and replaced by one kingdom after another. So he took a tremendous risk to go in. But he stepped out in faith because he knew it was such an incredible miracle that God had revealed this dream to him. And it was such an unusual dream that he was confident. How many know when God speaks to you by the Spirit and you know that you know it's God, you've got confidence. You don't let a little word from Satan or somebody else to tell you, you know, who do you think you are? I'm a child of the Most High God, called of God, placed in this region to do the work of God. And it's because of his call, not about anything with me. It has nothing to do with us. You see, God wanted to show forth his glory to King Nebuchadnezzar. So he took his servant, Daniel, a man pure before him, who sought him. And he took him and he showed forth his glory to this king that was so mighty and powerful at the time. No one would dare speak against this king. He was so powerful. So we too must trust God in these desperate times, sometimes physical challenges, sometimes relational things going on. God has not changed as Jesus Christ today, yesterday, and forever. Yes, from the time of the first existence of the day and from this day forth, I am he. And there is no one who can deliver out of my hand. I will work, and who can hinder? That's the Word we serve. You see, so when you know that you read this, we've got to be soaked in the Word, because in the Word, we learn who God is and how he works, right? So we see how great he is, and that's what I'm trying to get across tonight, is how great our God is. And our faith is based on his character and who he is. See, you cannot base faith on feelings, circumstance, some doctrine. You've got to put it on a mighty God. Amen. And he's the object of our faith. See?
Amen.
And Daniel obviously knew this God enough to trust him to go in and risk his life because he was going to die anyway. So then Arioch quickly brought Daniel. Arioch worked for King Nebuchadnezzar. Before the king, and said to him, I have found a man among the Judean exiles who can let the king know the interpretation. The king said and replied to Daniel, whose name was Belshazzar, are you able to tell me the dream I had and its interpretation? Now that was very tempting, wasn't it? Because Daniel could have said, oh yes, O king, I have the interpretation. Right? He could have been arrogant. He could have not given glory to God. I'm so great. I have this, you know. But what did he do? What he said is no man, no wise man, medium, divine priest, or astrologer is able to make known to the king the mystery he asked him. But there is a God in heaven.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. But there is a God in heaven,
yes,
who reigns over the nations. But there is a God in heaven in control, no matter what ISIS or the terrorist threats.
Amen.
There is a God in heaven, regardless of the financial insecurity. And if you're doing the reading I'm doing, it's pretty scary. And the healthcare issue that's going on with the increase. There is a God in heaven, no matter how bad the moral decline is or the spiraling decadence in this nation. There is a God in heaven who is watching out for us as his children, even while our freedoms are being eroded and we see incredible corruption going on in this nation. There is a God in heaven, regardless of how much they put marriage down and flaunt same-sex marriage. There is a God in heaven who's reigning over, and he's working. And he's doing awesome, mighty things.
Yes.
And we need
Amen.
To let this sink in.
Amen.
Not to just our heads,
Amen.
But to our hearts. That we know there's a bedrock conviction.
Amen.
That our God Almighty, the I Am that I Am,
Amen.
Is still at work. Yes, he's given man free will. He has. And that's why you see the evil over the world. God does not force anyone to serve him or do anything. There's evil abounding, and it will abound until Jesus comes. But there is a God in heaven that reigns. And no matter how wicked, and you have to understand, this King Nebuchadnezzar, these gods that they had, and the decadent things they did, and the sexual stuff they did, it was an abomination to God. And poor Daniel had to serve in this mess. He's a God of a righteous God serving in this sea. So God knows, and he's looking down, And he wants us to have a bedrock conviction that there's a God in heaven reigning, and he's in control of what's happening in this country right now. But he does look to us to pray like Daniel did.
Yes.
We're to pray and fast and to seek his face as never before. I spoke to someone this morning who was so upset about what's going on in the country. She said, will you ask your people to pray? I said, absolutely. I will ask them and encourage them to continue to pray ferociously for the nation and to fast. You see, because power, there's power in prayer. And there's an old song and it says, be sure your anchor holds and grips the solid rock. His name is Jesus. His name is Jesus. So Daniel goes on and he lets King Nebuchadnezzar know what the dream, that what happened in the last days. He tells him what it means. Your dream and the visions that came into your mind as you lay in your bed were these. You see, and he told him that, and he was very fortunate that the king heard him. Because the king, he didn't have good news. He had bad news. But the king knew that if this man could interpret my dream and tell me the dream, there had to be an almighty, awesome God. What an incredible testimony to Nebuchadnezzar. What an incredible thing for him to see. There's another God so great that he had to give him glory. And I'll read the scripture a little bit later. And now there's one thing. It's one thing to give an interpretation, but it's another thing to give the dream, isn't it?
Amen.
As for you, O king, he who reveals secrets was making known to you what shall come to pass. But praise God, he knows the future. And he reveals secrets. He reveals mysteries, doesn't he?
Yes.
It's amazing. It's amazing. But Daniel never took credit, and we are not to take credit. If God speaks a word through you or gives you insight, it is God Almighty. It is his spirit. We do not take credit. You see, God has got to know he can trust us. He will not reveal things to us if we take the credit. He's got to know, first of all, we'll do what he says, and he's got to know he can trust us.